Hi, I am Nazmi from ADS. I am camera technician. Today we going to explain how to lay the cabling, testing, commissioning for the CCTV cameras. First of all, to install the CCTV cameras, first step is you have to find the what is the angle you going to cover from the CCTV. So we can advise you can use your one eye. For the vision, the one eye vision is equal to your CCTV camera vision. If you what the things you see in your one eye, the camera also same vision it will take and record. So what we do, we have to install 6 cameras in this office. The first thing I tell you, we have to find out what is the best place to fix the camera for in this room. So in this room, if somebody entering, if you fix in that corner, it's a better place. By you know. That corner, if you fix the camera, you can see the clear face of the person who entering this room. If you fix in this corner, you can see the people but not their face. So what we suggest is you have to see with your one eye, and you have to recognize what the features of the person you can understand from the CCTV camera. So we suggest to fix the camera in the corner. So we have to lay the cable from here. This is the camera. Sir, this is my technician, Ahmed.
Chillin.
Hello, my name is Ahmed. I'm from EDS Sevi. I have configuration for the server CCTV installation.
Okay. Like that. We are connecting the DV. There is the two parts here. First, the cameras. We are connecting all the cables from the camera to the NVR. NVR means network video recorder. So we are placing here. So from here, each and every cable for the camera have to go here. So what we do is, like this a false ceiling area, we cannot pull everywhere, you cannot cut the ceilings, it will damage. So in each and every area you can use the lights, you can remove the lights from that space, you have to pull the cable. That's why we are removing this light and we are using to pull the cable from here, because we cannot cut each and everywhere to pull the cable. So better way what is if in the ceiling there will be a speakers, there will be a lights, there will be a shade. So you have to plan to remove them first. From that space you can use to pull your cable. Now
bring the cable to pull one time. You cannot pull each and every cable each time. So we have to pull the cable one time. So now we are planning, we are measuring the cable, then we'll pull one time, we'll finish the work.
Come.
Easy.
We have some techniques to do measurement. You can count how many tiles here. It's 2 feet tiles. So from there you can plan the cable. No need to go on measurement. No need. So we can count the tiles. On that we can plan how many cable will go there. And for the server you have to put 3 meters down. For the cameras, in the camera end you have to keep 1 meter for the maintenance. Now we already planned the cable how many meters. We are tied up all the cable. But normally what the people do, they will tie the cable and they will throw from the ceiling. So it will block somewhere. It's unprofessional way. What we do, we are using your normal case trunking. You can see the trunking like that. You all know this trunking. So we are using the trunking to pull the cable from this end to another end. So it will be a professional way and a very neat way. You can check this one. We will tie up all the cable in the trunking and we are putting the trunking through the ceiling to up to the end. So now my guy will pull the cable, you can see easily.
Now we reach the cable, 5 cable and trunking inside, they are pulled the cable, other end already the cable is reached. In that area, the segregated 5 places of cameras, each cable will be segregated. Every cameras we can easily, we can one shot, we can pull the camera from the inside of the trunking, and we are pull the cameras one by one. Now you are watching how we are one end we are pushing the 5 cables and centralized to be segregated to each place, and 5 places will be easily we can pull the camera. Because some people, what they do mistakenly, they will throw the cables and damage with the false link. Now without any make damage, it will be difference to compare with other people. Very smartly they are pull the camera from the trunking inside and centralized to be segregated to each cameras and separate cable. One shot easily we can, one by one the cable will be segregated to each cameras.
Now we already take the 5 cables. Now we are going to distribute each and every cable for each camera. This is the horse cutter, so we will make hole to where we need the camera, and we'll put the cable there, and we'll do the crimping, and we'll connect to the NVR. Now we are making one camera there and also here. So what we have to check is, it has to be symmetric, means one same lines have to be symmetric. Every day you have to plan symmetric, then only it look nice. You cannot fix camera that side from the wall 1 meter, this camera from the wall 2 meter. You have to fix same 1 meter 1 meter, so it's called symmetric. Now we are distributing cables to the hole, and we keep 1 meter length for the maintenance. We are fixing 2 cameras, one here and another one there.
Now we are making unboxing for UNV, for camera, IP camera. This IP cameras is HD quality and smart IR anti-reflection window, wide input voltage range 25%, on VAIF compliant. We are doing for unboxing for UNV cameras. This for screws and locks and fixing from the camera frame, and you can use for the screws. See, this is for the zooming camera. It's a fixing lens, and but you can mobile view, you can zoom the view also. It's like a round, and the shape is, camera is this rounding shape. This for cable, for a connector, for NVR connector. You can connect for this connector only. You can connecting with view purpose and power POE for LAN cable through. It will work with the.
This is a grooming tool. You can use this FTZ tool. This is the cable, CAT6 cable. This is CAT6 RJ45 connector. So now we do the grooming. So you have to measure like this amount. and you have to strip like this. You have to strip this one, then there is a 8 core cable, get 6 8 core cable. So we will remove these things. Then you have to like this. After this, you have to arrange. Most people know the coloring code. The green have to come here. You have to arrange it inside to make it easy. So first arrange like this. You can use a player or screwdriver. I'll use my hands. It's quite easy for me. So you can all know the K6 cable color code: white, orange, orange, then white, green, after that blue, and first we have to run like this. Then blue, white, blue, green, then brown,
I think you are memorized the color code. That's why you are doing
in the Google also they have the color code. If you Google it, you can get this color
this
code.
This is straight through color code or which kind?
This is not straight, it's crossover color code. So normally for all devices, nowadays we are using crossover, the straight crossover, now they will take automatically, no problem, it will switch. Now devices are like this. So then you have to cut.
The cables are will be only same shape, you are cutting the cable.
Yes, now this one if you go inside, it will be nice looking. If it is come here, it will break the cable. So we have to put this sleeve inside. It will be a professional way. Then we have to check white, orange, orange, white, green, blue, white, blue, green, then white, brown, brown. You have to check this side, and also you have to check this side. So you can see all the cable here. Then you start grooming the cable. Now you can test the cable through this one. It punch here, at last it punch here, then it's perfect.
now we are installing the NVR. This is the NVR. We remove like this with the screws. And now we are installing the hard disk, 4 TB hard disk. So when you see, this is the SATA cable for data transfer. This one for the power. So when you install, you have to check this one reach here. So you cannot install like this. So first you have to decide to install like this. Then it will reach here. This, you know, this SATA cable, you can fix here. This is for data, this is for power.
This order is only for specialized for NVR only, or we can use for desktop computer also?
No, this purple color for the surveillance hard drive. This is called, we have 3 colors. This purple for the surveillance hard drive is mentioned. The red color for server, blue color normal for the desktops.
What is the difference between surveillance hard drive? It will be very speed to store the video.
No, only thing, it will overwrite. They have some function inside the one software, it will overwrite first in, first out, like that.
Okay. But this one we cannot use for computer also.
Computer we cannot use.
This is only for
surveillance purpose, surveillance. Overwriting.
In NVR, what are the outputs of their ports? Can you explain the ports?
Yeah, we have, this is 8-channel NVR. We can connect 8 cameras. This is for internet. For the mobile application, this is USB for the mouse, this HDMI output for the TV, or you can connect monitor.
Okay.
This is a POE port, this inbuilt POE also. This port, not only the
RJ45
data and power, POE, okay, power POE. Over internet, Ethernet.
How much cost for this? Cost price for NVR?
In Qatar riyal, 600 something.
Without NVR, we cannot control the camera.
No, this is the network recording unit. For the camera, you need recording unit. So this is only the recording unit. This NVR have inbuilt software to view, to store playback. They have some software. So you need to monitor, you need software. No, this is all inbuilt.
All cameras is IP cameras.
Yes.
Without NVR, we cannot see from the view from the mobile.
No, we need NVR because you have to put NVR in the online, then only it will come to your mobile application. Okay. Directly you cannot connect.
That camera is not individually not be reacted to online.
Yes.
It will depend the NVR only.
NVR only, yes. cameras. This is entrance. This is PT set camera. You can move like this, PT set control. So this is the control of PT set control. We can move the camera like this. And we can do zoom, the optical zoom, then it will align, then zoom out.